Ankit is a smart child who studies in 6th grade. His grandfather is a retired officer from the Environment Department. Ankit was inspired a lot from his grandfather. Grandpa's teachings had raised a lot of curiosity in Ankit's mind regarding the environment. Once on Ankit's suggestion, all his classmates along with his teacher went to the beach to clean it. Ankit's best friend Pavan and his sister were also among those kids. Cleaning of the beach took a lot of time. After hours of hard work, the children were fatigued and became hungry. Their teacher had already brought bread and vegetables for them from school itself. The children were so hungry that they finished all the food in split of a second. But then a problem arrived.
Oh, I forgot to bring water.
Madam, I have a bottle of water, but it won't be enough for everyone.
Teacher thought for a moment and then started smiling.
Students, today I will take an exam of yours. All of you have to arrange drinking water from nature for each one of us.
But madam, there is not even a house anywhere nearby.
And there is so much salt dissolved in the sea water. We can't even drink this water because it can be highly dangerous for our health.
Correct, Sonia. It is difficult. That is why I'm calling it an exam.
All the kids got excited.
And
teacher, water is also present underneath the ground. If all of us dig the ground, we will find water.
Oh no, we are already tired after so much of hard work. Now do you want to take our lives?
Jatin, your idea is nice, but it's pretty difficult. Think of something else.
Jatin smiles and starts thinking again. An idea crosses Pavan's mind and he said,
"We can do it easily."
How so?
See, there is so much water in the ocean.
Stupid, haven't you heard? The sea water contains a lot of salt and can be fatal for us.
I heard that. But we can extract drinking water from that.
But how?
For that, first we need to wash the utensils we have used. Let's wash those big bowls. Jatin, do one thing. Go there and bring some firewood.
Come, Jatin. You and some more children come with me and we will bring some firewood.
Rest of the children washed the utensils and in a while, firewoods were also arranged. Meanwhile, Pavan fills the bowl with seawater. He takes matchbox from the teacher and ignites the firewood. With Ankit's help, he puts the bowl filled with water on the fire and covers it with a lid.
Well done, Pavan!
I got it. The water will evaporate and the salt will remain in the bowl. And as the lid is cool, the steam will hit and would turn into the water again. And this water will be drinkable.
Excellent, Sonia!
But there is still an issue. The cool water will fall back in the bowl. Then how will we drink it?
There is a solution to this issue as well. Ankit, please help me a bit.
Ankit took some sticks and lifts the lid. Teacher helps him with a cloth. The teacher makes a slope with the help of the sticks so that the lid is tilted from which the water can slide down on one side where Ankit puts another bowl on that side. In a while, fresh water starts getting accumulated in the other bowl.
Well done, children! You have passed the exam together. Well, do you know that the drinking water which is supplied to our houses also comes through these kind of processes only?
Madam, let me tell this. All these processes depict the water cycle. The seawater evaporates and goes up due to the sunlight and forms clouds in the atmosphere. When this water vapor cools down, it falls back on the earth in the form of rain and snow if it becomes extremely cold. And yes, rainwater or the water from melting snow makes rivers from which we get drinking water. Hint.
Very good. Okay, tell me, does all the water flow back to rivers?
Madam, there is water underneath the ground as well. Some of the water drains out to rivers. But the rest is soaked up by the earth. We can use that water with the help of wells and hand pumps.
And the water flowing in the rivers mixes with oceans or seas again.
Absolutely. And this is how the water cycle keeps going on and on. Children, well done. All of you have understood the subjects taught to you. Now, drink water one by one. Then, we also need to return. I will give all of you an ice cream treat on our way back.
Yay!
Ankit was really happy from yesterday's cleaning campaign. He was pondering over the importance of water since then. Today is Sunday. His friend Pavan had asked him to come over his place for playing. Ankit loves to both play and study with Pavan. This is because Pavan is bright in both studies and sports. Although Ankit dislikes his habit of carelessness, Ankit's parents owned a dairy farm. When Ankit reached Pavan's house in the evening, he was taking a shower. After waiting for some time, Ankit went to the courtyard. Pavan's mother was watering the plants over there. She seemed to be a bit tensed.
What happened, auntie? Why do you look tense?
Oh, Ankit, come. See, I had thought of creating a fine garden in my courtyard. Just a week ago, I have planted these plants and I take so much care of these flowers and water them every day. All the plants are growing, but I don't know why these thorny plants are dying.
Auntie, why do you water these plants every day? These thorny plants belong to the species of cactus and they need very less water to survive. Perhaps these must be dying due to excess of water.
Ah, oh my God. And see, I water them every other day, thinking that they may need more water.
No, auntie. Have a look. The whole flower bed is full of water. It is actually like floods for these plants.
This is a correct simile. If water is more than the need, it can do a lot of damage as well. Even excess rainfall causes floods, drowning houses, streets, and even forests.
Yes, auntie. During floods, water seeps into the tiny pores present in the soil and replaces the air present in these pores. Because of this, organisms living in soil and the roots of trees could not breathe and eventually dies. Many living beings also die because of drowning. Crops are ruined. Just like that, these flower beds seems to be flood prone.
From now on, I will water these cactuses once in a few weeks only. Just then, Pavan, who was listening to Ankit's conversation for a while, comes from behind.
No, mother. Watering them once or twice a week is necessary. Otherwise, they will get dry and eventually die. Just like the time of drought, when there is a scarcity of rainfall, rivers and ponds dry up. It's a big problem for the areas where groundwater level is very low.
Wow, mister, you know everything. Still, you waste so much water by taking shower for hours. Is it right?
Rightly said, Ankit. Answer him, Pavan.
Actually, Mother, what will happen if I only use a little more water?
See that? So much water gets wasted on our dairy farm. Pavan, don't you think we should do something about that first?
But we are helpless in that. Water is needed to bathe the animals and wash their stables.
Auntie, I have a solution to fix this issue. You can use all this water again by filtering it.
Filter? We have a water filter at our home, but that is way too expensive. How are we going to install a filter on such a large scale?
Ankit, I think it's a good idea though. We can filter water naturally as well. Why don't we show the process which we learned while doing the science project to her?
Pavan and Ankit brought a water bottle from inside. Then Ankit cuts it from the bottom. Both kids placed a cloth at the top of the bottle first.
Then, one by one, they made layers of coarse sand, charcoal, fine sand, and gravel till the top.
Pavan pours dirty water in it. In a while, water droplets start falling from the mouth of the bottle.
See, Auntie, you can make such a natural water filter on a large scale. With the help of this, water can be reused.
Well done! This seems to be an old but nice method. Why don't we think of something even bigger? When it rains, a lot of water drains in a small time period. Tell me, how can we use that water?
Yes, it reminded me of rainwater harvesting. Mother, please tell us a bit more on rainwater harvesting.
The objective of rainwater harvesting is that water, instead of getting wasted, could get harvested for future use. If we assume the roof as a funnel and attach a pipe to it to collect water, a lot of water can be harvested in this way. Now, you both think and tell me, what shall be done?
Mother, we can build a huge tank where rainwater will get collected, which can be used at the time of need. The tank shall be covered all the times so that the water doesn't get evaporated.
Yes, absolutely. We can do one more thing. The rainwater which gets collected on the roof can be transported through a pipe to be a small tank which can be further connected to groundwater. By this method, rainwater will get mixed with groundwater. If we keep the floor and roof of the house slanting towards the tank, then the rainwater of the surrounding area will also seep into the earth. By doing this, we will not face water scarcity problem throughout the year.
Alright kids, I will call Vishnu Plumber tomorrow only to get the systems installed. We will welcome the rain together this year.
Ankit brother, if the lesson on saving the environment is complete, shall we go to play?